Okay, so this is clear, right? So why are we naming it like this, or what is the name of the reaction? Catalytic addition of steam. Now why am I calling it catalytic addition of steam? Because we are adding a catalyst, which is sulfuric acid. The type of reaction is addition reaction, and the reagent we are adding is steam. So we are adding steam to ethene in presence of a catalyst, and the product which we are getting is an alcohol, which is ethanol. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me take it ahead from here. Now there is a simple problem in this kind of reaction. What is the problem I am showing you? The similar problem we have faced in substitution reaction. See, suppose we are taking propene. Propene also has a double bond, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now when you are taking propene and you are doing the same reaction, that means you are adding steam, which is H and OH, in presence of dilute sulfuric acid. Okay. Now the same thing. Okay, very simple. The first is a CH3, so it will remain like that only, no change. Now second, we have a double bond, so we will keep one of the bond and we will break the other one. Now when we break the other one, see, now I will distinguish. I get one free hand in the middle carbon and one free hand in the last carbon. Now I have two things to add, H and OH, correct? So what I do here, I put H with the red one and I put OH with the green one, correct? Okay. Now you see, you can understand, I think you can guess what I am trying to show. Now I want to add water in a different way, because the same kind of problem we have faced in substitution. Can you link? That we have two optional products. Either you get this one or you get this one. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now the same thing. I am breaking it. So I get one red and I get one green. But now I will change. I will put OH with the red one. And I will put H with the green one.
Yeah.
So are we getting the same product? We are getting positional isomers. Here we are getting propanol. But here we are getting 2-propanol. Correct? So you see that in this kind of reaction, we may obtain mixture of products which are positional isomers of each other. Correct?
Yes.
Clear? And this is very, very similar to the problem we have seen during substitution.
Yes.
Do you remember, or should I remind you? That if you take propene, we did this already. If you take propene, you have an option to replace the hydrogen at carbon 2 or the hydrogen at carbon 1. Correct?
Yeah.
If you do this one, you get 2-chloropropane. If you do this one, you get 1-chloropropane.
Yeah.
So you have a mixture of products. Fine?
Yes.
Okay. Hydration is done. Bromine water addition is done, hydrogen addition is also done. Okay, I will just show you one simple exam. Okay, this is not required. Halogen, hydrohalogenation. Let me just show you one example. Which one?
Hydrohalogenation.
Yeah, hydrohalogenation. Okay, let me write the name. This is known as hydrohalogenation. Now you can easily understand from the name that what am I going to add? I am going to add HX. That means I am going to add hydrogen and one halogen. Okay? Hydrohalogenation. Very simple. I will just show you one example. Suppose you are taking HCl. Then you break one of the hand. So you put H in one of them and X in the other one. Oh, sorry, we have taken chlorine. So let me write chlorine only. So H in one of the hand and chlorine in the other one. Correct? Okay. Now try to understand the beauty of organic chemistry. You are preparing this compound from ethene. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, we can also prepare the same compound from ethane. See. What would be the process? Chlorine in presence of sunlight. We can do this or not? See, we are getting the same product. The product is chloroethane, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Huh. When we are preparing this from ethane, then what kind of reaction are we doing? Substitution. And when we are preparing it from an alkene, which is ethene, then what kind of reaction are we doing? Addition. Understood? But we are getting the same product.
Yeah.
Okay. Copied?
Yes, sir. Copied.
Hmm. Okay. Now see. Now I will come to the next category, which is oxidation. Oxidation of alcohols. Okay. Suppose I'm taking an alcohol like this. And I'm trying to oxidize it. What does this symbol represents?
Oxidation.
So how do we represent reduction? What should I write within the square bracket? No. This is oxidation. But if you write it like this, H within a square bracket, then that indicates reduction. Okay. So when you write oxygen within square bracket, don't take it as O. It is oxygen. So if you write oxygen within square bracket, that means it shows that it's an oxidation process. But if you write hydrogen within the square bracket, then it shows that it's a reduction process. Fine? Now see, how we are oxidizing it. Think about this hydrogen and think about this hydrogen. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Suppose we are removing those two hydrogen. So finally, what we will get, let us not do it like this. This particular group, CH2OH, we will change into this. Like this. So what is the change I am doing? See, we have this group, CH2OH, correct? And this group we are changing to this, COOH. So we are changing this to a carboxylic acid. Correct? Okay. Now, why do I consider this as an oxidation? Look at the change. Here we have 1, 2, 3 hydrogen and here we have only 1 hydrogen. Correct? So, first of all, we have loss of 2 hydrogen atoms. And one more thing also we did. We have done addition of 1 oxygen atom. Now we know this from our previous knowledge that adding oxygen and removing hydrogen is oxidation. So why are we considering this as an oxidation? First of all, we are removing hydrogen. How many hydrogen we are removing? Two hydrogen atoms. And secondly, this is an oxidation because you are adding oxygen. Correct?
Yes.
Tell me, clear or not?
Clear.
Okay. Copied?
Yeah.
Now, what are the reagents for oxidation? What reagent we will be using for oxidation? See, check the reagents. The main reagents for oxidation are, number one, we will talk about two reagents. This is known as potassium dichromate, or we can say, actually this is acidified potassium dichromate. I will tell you why acidified, what is potassium dichromate, I will explain. Okay. How do we write this? We write this like this. K2Cr2O7H+. Okay. Now how do we prepare this? First we take this potassium dichromate crystals, K2Cr2O7. And these crystals are orange in color. They are orange crystals. Note the color carefully. We need to know about this. Now when we take the crystal, then suppose we have taken a beaker. Now we have distilled water within the beaker. So we will dissolve this crystal within the beaker. And when dissolving the crystal, we will add some concentrated sulfuric acid to dissolve the crystals. If you simply add the crystal to water, it will not dissolve. If you add concentrated sulfuric acid, it will dissolve. And finally, when you take the crystal, dissolve it in water, and you add concentrated sulfuric acid to it as well, the thing which you get is a orange solution. Okay. So K2Cr2O7 is basically a orange solution. And sometimes in simple words, we also represent it like this. Cr2O7 2- H+. So now you can understand why we are writing the H+. Because the H+ is coming from H2SO4. Right?
Why don't you write the potassium in the second one?
Actually, potassium, if we look at the reaction, the potash, that is when I will give you the complete reaction, that means alcohol with the oxidizing agent, you will see that potassium doesn't play any role there. It remains as a spectator ion. Spectator ion means an ion present in the reaction but as an audience, not as a participant. So that is known as a spectator ion. See, if I, when I will write the complete reaction, you will understand that potassium over here is a spectator ion. It doesn't participate in the reaction. So that is why we are not interested to write about it.
Okay.
Now number two, another reagent we can use, that is acidified potassium manganate. Potassium manganate within bracket, within bracket Roman 7. I will tell you why Roman 7. Now this is what? This is KMnO4 / H+. Okay, now what is the oxidation number of potassium, you see, a manganese, then you will understand why Roman 7. Potassium is +1, correct? And let manganese be taken as X. Then what we can write, 1 + X + we have 4 oxygen atoms. So 4 times minus 2. Because each oxygen is minus 2.
Yeah.
So 4 oxygen, 4 times minus 2 is equal to 0. So that gives you that x is equal to plus 7.
Yes.
Which means that the oxidation number of manganese over here will be plus 7. Fine? And this solution is pink in color. It is prepared in the same way. You take the crystals of potassium permanganate, which are pink crystals, dissolve it in water and add sulfuric acid. Then you will get a pink color solution. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Now let us see the overall reaction of oxidation. See. Let us take this example. So suppose we have taken CH3CH2OH. So that is ethanol. Right? Now this ethanol is reacting with potassium dichromate. Now instead of writing potassium dichromate, let me write it like this. I have splitted it. Don't get confused. Instead of writing potassium dichromate, I have broken it into ions.
Yes.
Why? To answer your question. You asked me, no? That's a why can we ignore potassium? I want to show you that. Now, what is the product I am getting? See, this was an alcohol. It was ethanol. So, definitely what product I will get? I will get a carboxylic acid. So I am getting ethanoic acid. Now this dichromate which I have taken, this Cr2O7 minus will change into this compound. Cr2O3. Whereas potassium will remain as potassium. I am not balancing the equation. Let me tell you. Don't check the balancing. It's not a balanced equation. I want to show you something else. Now you see here, the first point which I want to show you. We have 2K plus here, we have 2K plus here. So did it participate in the reaction?
No.
No. So that means it's a spectator ion.
Yes,
in many redox reactions you will see this concept. Spectator ion. Spectator ion means an ion which do not participate in the reaction.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you see. This is CH2OH is converted into COOH. So we have already studied this, that this is very plain and simple oxidation. Isn't it? Why? Because you are losing two hydrogen atoms and you are adding one oxygen atom. So this is oxidation. Now over here in Cr2, okay, let me show you here. Cr2O7 minus, suppose chromium I am taking as X. So what is the oxidation number? 2 times of X plus 7 times of minus 2 is equal to minus 2. Because the overall charge is minus 2.
Yes.
And there are 7 oxygen atoms and each oxygen atom is minus 2. So X is equal to, hello,